the part of all those who treasure life and freedom. The pain that prevails cannot and should not be put aside. It feeds our memories so that we cannot forget, and very importantly, we cannot forgive. The truth must be told over and over again that even prior to 9/11/2001, America had been attacked by Muslim jihadists. The first attack on the World Trade Center was 1993, and despite destruction and death, it did not serve to be a wake-up call to America. The Obama leadership today would still like us to be asleep. We are lulled with myths of mindless multiculturalism. Interfaith dialogues are encouraged to promote interdenominational understanding. In today's modern world, there's been no lack of understanding amongst Jews, Christians, Buddhists, Hindus, and so forth. What the Obama world is promoting is engagement and understanding and appeasement of Islam, the pretense that it is a peaceful religion, not the intolerant ideology that it was defined as just before. The Obama administration would have us believe that Islam is deserving of having its mosques throughout the United States, including here in Ground Zero, that it should have its chaplains preaching in our prisons, that everyone should respect the sanctity of the Quran, while all along war is being waged under our noses. Even today, while we are standing here, all our security forces are focused on protecting us from yet another attack from Islam. Thankfully, President Bush's counterterrorism program has succeeded in foiling at least 40 plots that we know of since 9/11. Will Obama's reluctant extension of these programs continue to protect us? President Obama is unable to name the enemy. The enemy's name is radical Islam. When he lists countries attacked by terrorism, he incredulously omits Israel, the country that has suffered endlessly from Islamic suicide bombers and terrorists. The toll of Israeli dead from Islamic terrorism is in the thousands, with many more thousands injured. The numbers keep growing as rocket attacks continue on a daily basis from Hamas, Iran's surrogate in Gaza. Islamic terrorism has claimed the lives of over 6,000 U.S. soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan, with 45,000 wounded. Just today, a Taliban bomb in Afghanistan claimed more American lives. We are at war. Iran is undoubtedly the free world's biggest enemy today, threatening us with nuclear war. Irrationally and dangerously, Obama has assured the enemy that there will be no military response from the U.S. So who is to stop them? And Iran's Ahmadinejad is permitted on U.S. soil, allowed into New York City, applauded at the General Assembly, where he will once again spew his hatred of the West and his intentions to wipe out Israel. The UN, which is dominated by Islamic countries, will accept this venom and continue with its condemnation of Israel at the infamous Durban III. The General Assembly will be asked to approve another Arab terrorist state, the quote, Palestinian, unquote, state inside of Israel, and will undoubtedly welcome it with open arms. This will be the signal to the Arab world to attack Israel and will signal the lack of will on the part of the free Western world to resist this additional declaration of war. What is the answer? Americans must be told the truth. Americans must speak the truth. Americans must know the truth. Global Islamic terrorism is out to destroy Europe. The little Satan, Israel. The big Satan, America. The only answer lies in the eradication of the Islamic threat. The only answer lies in victory.